And history repeating itself. Oh!
DraftKings Sportsbook is an official partner of WWE. And right now, new customers can bet just $5 to get $150 in bonus bets instantly. Download the app, use code WWE, and make your bets today.
The biggest moonsault you'll ever witness.
Not quite. Kofi Kingston using the shield to his advantage yet again. And Kofi Kingston won't back down. He's going to meet Ivar. Ivar top rope. Kingston now on the apron. Glancing down. Using the beard of Ivar. Through the table. Grabbing the beard of Ivar and launching Ivar through the table.
And it's all perfect.
Oh my God, wait, look at this, look at this. Valhalla. Valhalla launching herself off the announce table. Taking out Kingston. Remember, no disqualifications. And here comes Xavier Woods. What is wrong with her? What a frightening, frightening sight. Woods, you may want to run.
Woods doesn't know what to do.
Oh, and he ducks underneath, and Valhalla goes flying into the timekeeper's area. Pancaking Xavier Woods with a cross body into the barricade. Kingston back to his feet.
I have no idea how Ivar got onto his feet after that landing through the table. He's ripe for the pickings now, though. It's all Kingston.
And Kofi Kingston back in the ring. Has Ivar right where he wants him.
Trouble in.
Uh-oh, no. Intercepted by Ivar. Driving Kofi through a table. Kingston went for trouble in paradise and Ivar countered.
What carnage in that ring, and everywhere you look, Cole. Kingston decimated.
And now Ivar with Kingston down and out. Ivar climbing up toward the top rope.
When you're this big and this agile, gravity is a dangerous weapon.
300 pounds! Moonsault to Kingston! Ivar wins Viking rules!
Here is your winner, Ivar!
Get Wilson.
Bochazo. No. Gonna break his fingers. Oh!
Swing and a miss from Bush.
Shillelagh
to Prince.
Elton got him with the shillelagh.
Oh, Bush! Bush out in time.
Elton trying to figure out what he's got to do to put the brutes away.
We're going to make a climb to the high rent district, but Ridge put the brakes on. Oh, no. No, please, no. No, boy!
Oh, through a table!
Kit, don't turn around.
Don't turn around. It's a bro kick, and not to Shamo. What a kick out by Kit.
Yeah, bro kick, Butch style.
What a battle this is here on Friday Night SmackDown. Good old-fashioned Donnybrook.
Oh, dear.
And we're not done yet because Ridge is bringing out yet another table.
Elton Prince on the far side, somewhere trying to recover. Meanwhile, Kit Wilson in a perilous position with both brawling brutes loading up the table.
Well, Kit just trying to scramble out of harm's way.
Butch barking orders at Ridge to go get him. Oh, that backfired spectacularly.
Well scouted by Kit Wilson. Now face first, Butch into the turnbuckle.
With a heavy chop.
It's chest to be mincemeat.
Oh, no!
All over Butch. And the mangy mutt's in big time trouble here.
Through the table.
Victory for Pretty Deadly.
Here are your winners, Pretty Deadly.
Can I get a yes, boy? What a fight. Unfortunately for Priest, Bunny has not. Oh!
Almost like Priest suckered him in.
I think you're absolutely right. A world-traveled veteran of this industry, Damian Priest. Not about to be embarrassed in his own home. Writhing in pain on the outside of the ring. And I don't believe the pain is going to subside anytime soon. The custom Puerto Rican kendo stick, courtesy of Savio Vega.
Now being used on Buddy.
It's high, it's deep, it's not coming back.
Bunny was impressive early, but Damian Priest has slowed things down. And now he drives back Bunny into the timekeeper's area. And Priest now oozing with confidence. Mocking.
Priest not concerned with endearing himself to his fellow Puerto Ricans tonight.
It's about embarrassing the biggest star on the planet. That's what it's about for Damian Priest. But Bunny's no battling back.
Bunny's not going to go down without a fight. Exploring the real estate here.
Well, he might want to, or else he may not make Coachella next year.
Priest with a kick rocked Benito for the moment.
Over in the tech area, the engineering area.
This is getting dangerous. I have a feeling Bad Bunny may rue the day he accepted this match.
What is Priest planning to do here?
He's planning to send Bunny on an early farewell tour.
And put Bad Bunny fighting back high on top of that equipment.
Oh no, oh no.
This is not gonna be good!
No!
Oh my God! Sami Zayn! Bouncing Balor off the desk, and now Sami up top!
Somersault senton taking out the Judgment Day.
And again, Dominic picking his spot. And now Dominic being assaulted by Kevin Owens. Not to say Mysterio doesn't deserve this. And Kevin Owens, he has got bad intentions here.
Kevin Owens with a right hand right between the eyes of Dominic Mysterio.
Dominic better figure out now where he is quickly.
No, Kevin.
Because Kevin Owens is climbing up high.
This will not end well.
Kevin Owens. Climbing to the top of that stairwell. Owens! Threw Dominic through the table with a swanton!
Seth's passion second to none, as evidenced by the fact he is willing to put himself through physical hell for the prestigious World Heavyweight Championship. Seth promised to be a fighting champion, and boy, has he lived up to that promise thus far.
And now Rollins driven right into that barrier there by Nakamura. Fighting over on the edge of the stands near the technical area. And
face first off of the unforgiving road case. And what on earth is Nakamura cooking up now?
Well, anything he wants to. Lying on the edge of the stairs, on the edge of the WWE fans here in Indianapolis. Nakamura continues to climb higher with Seth Rollins in tow. This is for the World Heavyweight Championship, held by Seth Rollins. Last man standing. No pinfall, submission, countouts or disqualifications. The only way you win. Oh, and Rollins is
really making use of the fact that there is no disqualification.
And oh, and a low blow.
And oh no.
Oh my goodness. Did you see Rollins' body buckle as he was kicked out of the stands to the floor below by Nakamura? Rollins writhing in pain.
I think the worst thing about Seth Rollins is the fact that he accepted this, that the champion willingly accepted this matchup, these circumstances, this stipulation, and it could prove to be the end of Seth Rollins. I don't mean just his championship reign, I mean the end of Rollins as a WWE superstar.
No doubt. I mean, who knows if this man's gonna be able to walk again after this. Nakamura. And look at Rollins. Rollins saying, bring it. He's still somehow trying to taunt Nakamura. And Nakamura now trying to lift Seth Rollins up and put Rollins away once and for all. Rollins fights back with an elbow. And now Seth Rollins hooks up Shinsuke Nakamura for a pedigree.
How in the hell is Rollins finding the will
absolutely
to fight on?
No idea. Seth Rollins delivering a pedigree, finding himself back in this match with the World Heavyweight Championship on the line, and yet another stop by Rollins.
Well, now, I don't know if that was wise by the Cousins. Brutus taking full advantage.
Oh, no.
One thing about it, anything goes. It's no disqualification thing. Anything goes.
It's tables. It's ladders. It's scares. Here at Halloween Havoc Night 2, where three championships will be defended. And right now, Garza Carrillo taking advantage until Julius wipes him out.
Talk about the athletic prowess of this young man, Julius Creed, as well as Buda. They can do it all.
Table.
They can do it all.
Booker,
they can do it all.
Booker, what was your over-under on tables in this match?
Man, I didn't think about how many was going to come out, but guess what? Guess what? I'm loving it.
Look at the bruises on the back of Julius Creed. Look at the welts forming on the body of the Creed brothers.
No quitting. No quitting these young guys. I love it.
That adrenaline from that victory last night on Raw still pumping through the Creed brothers' veins here tonight.
Come on, to beat the Alpha Academy, I didn't think it was going to happen, but they went out there and proved me wrong, and I'm loving it, man.
Now what is on the mind of the Creeds as Julius back to the outside? This has been as physical, Booker, as you thought it would be. You said earlier to me today that they're going to leave it all hang out on Halloween Havoc.
No, I didn't think Julius and Buda was going to be able to come in and weather the storm. I'm talking about going
we saw this.
The deep waters, but we're here now, man.
Saw this last night happen to Alpha Academy. Garza trying to run a little bit of interference. Garza teetering. And look at Julius, finally Humberto trying to get off the shoulders of Julius Creed.
Oh no!
Crash and burn!
for Garza. Julius rising with Carrillo.
Wow.
Brutus Ball.
Trish just somehow tried, and look at Trish's trap point.
Oh God!
Trish's trap. Both of her legs are trapped inside the top of that steel cage. And Becky Lynch now trying to drag Trish back into the cage. Trish may have been able to slip down and win this match if she didn't get her leg caught in the top of the cage.
I think in this instance, it might be a blessing in disguise that Trish's leg did get caught in the top of the cage, because it is a long way down to the floor.
And Trish finally freeing herself from that steel prison. But Becky Lynch has got Trish Stratus under control, it seems. Oh my God, Stratus is some 15 to 20 feet in the air here. Not from up there, superplex! Get out of the way, Otis!
Oh!
Gotta do it. Cover by Ivar.
For the Viking Raiders to put away.
Save! Oh, thank you. Oh, he's not gonna do this. There's no way. Oh my! Oh my goodness! You gotta be kidding me!
Oh, we've seen this before. Gable to the top row.
Come on, Titus. Gable.
Oh!
There we go.
Diamond headbutt for the win for the Academy! Oh, look who it is!
Here's what you were waiting for, Titus!
Come on, Maxine! Come on, Maxine! Come on, give it to me! Yes!
Maxine enhancing her skills week after week. Titus, you're impressed now!
Oh, she's about to get it! She's about to graduate, guys! Here we go!
Maxine!
Here we go! Take your flowers now, baby!
And she graduated, but that's just a technicality.
Oh, spear through the table! Maxine Dupri spear through the table!
Gable obviously understandably concerned for Maxine's well-being. But this does not bode well for Gable. Big headbutt from Otis and a left jab. This is one of the wildest scenes I can ever remember seeing on Raw. There are Viking flags everywhere. There is Otis. If ever there was a time I needed you to bark, that was it.
Yep. I don't know if caterpillars bark.
Oh, I don't either.
It's not home.
Too big to be
out of nowhere.
Oh. Ivar with a double axe handle.
Oh no.
Oh,
this
no.
Spells trouble.
Oh no. This spells the end.
Oh. Look. The Viking Raiders to put away the Academy. And they've done it.
Here are your winners, the Viking Raiders!
And springboard! I have never seen anyone go through a barricade like that.
Tiffany Stratton is living up to the billing, Vic. She's living up to top billing, Vic.
Stratton with all her force. Oh no! Now going in and. Oh, ho, ho! Oh.
think things getting taken a little too deep.
You think?
Looking for that manhandle slam. That manhandle slam, though, countered, and oh! Oh, wait, no!
Oh, we get busy, man.
I'm almost in the front row. I can't believe these two have come up with the imaginable.
Talking about extreme, Vic, you about to see it.
To get back to the tippy top, Stratton. Swanton bomb! And now, the Gallus boys looking to be on top. Double cover.
This is it.
Ain't
this is
no
it, man.
Boy.
Whoa! Where'd he come from?
Bate willing to risk it all to keep this match afloat for the big, strong brutes. Well, if one table wasn't enough, I suppose you're happy that they're not coming through our table.
You say, Vic, all these guys are familiar with each other. They've seen this battle before right now. Just a different place, different time, but the same action, man. Oh, yes!
Again, it was butch-ass bait. Leave the zen, leave the meditation. I need the old Tyler Bate, who just got lifted and planted.
You can meditate later on, Vic. You cannot bring meditation into a fight like this. You got to be ready to go. It's going to be a lot of
Booker, you talk about,
and torn.
You talk about the numbers advantage, but look at Big Ridge. The strength to toss not one, but two men out of the way. And Joe Coffey now. All the best for the Bells. Swing and a miss. Knocking the kick down, then knocking Ridge down.
Wow.
And is this the moment for Joe Coffey? Is this the moment for Gallus?
Joe
Is
Coffey
this
got
the redemption
man.
Joe Coffey's been looking for? A powerbomb. Butch able to skim across the bridge of the nose. Oh, the best for the Bells.
I'll tell you something.
I'll tell you something.
Joe Coffey has been proving his wealth as far as being a leader in this team of Gallus. You gotta love it, Vic.
I thought that was your beer.
The bar fight. The bar fight.
No,
like
I didn't get a beer. A little insult to... He just broke that mug across the face of Coffey. And add him up. Triple. Powerbomb.
Wow.
Onto the broken glass.
That's
through
it.
The table. And the pub is closed for them Gallus boys.
Here are your winners, the team of